So let us see some more concepts. We have already seen, you know, we have already discussed these points. Now let us say a question is given like this. This is YDSC setup, alright, and there are two slits. The gap is the slit size is small d, and the screen to distance is capital D. Screen to screen one to this is slit to screen. This is slit, screen, distance is capital D, and this is the condition. You have to find out, the question given is at y is equal to d by 2, what are the missing wavelengths? Okay, so this is the y coordinate, right? So we have seen this, you know, you take a point, then you have seen the interference phenomenon, how it is happening here, you know, what we have done there. We have done our path difference, we have calculated. Now, in the question, what is asking you? What is this? How to look at P? This is my y coordinate. Okay, the coordinate of that point. Now, at y is equal to d by 2. See, the gap between the slits is d. So, this is the central line. So, d by 2 on top and d by 2 at the bottom. At y is equal to d by 2, what are the missing wavelengths? Missing wavelengths means the dark spots. Dark spots you are not able to see. So, when does dark interference is happening? When your path difference is, we have discussed, your path difference should be like lambda by 2, d lambda by 2, phi lambda by 2, so on and so forth, right? So, you can say delta x is lambda 1 by 2, 3 lambda 2 by 2, phi lambda 3 by 2. We are trying to find out the missing wavelength. When the path length is in this fashion, in this pattern, all these wavelengths, lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, so on, they all are missing wavelengths. So, delta x, when are you going to get the dark spot? What is the condition for getting a destructive interference? Okay, constructive interference is bright, destructive interference is giving you dark spots. When delta x is equal to 2n minus 1 by 2 into lambda. In this situation, actually you are getting the dark spots, right? But what is the, look here, delta x is given as, when the path difference is of this order, you are going to get the missing wavelengths. Okay, so delta x, what was the equation we have, how we have derived delta x? Delta x is equal to, see, considering these two light rays as parallel, we have told that this is our path difference, isn't it? So this was delta x is equal to, if I say this total length is d, it is d sine theta. This and this basically is same. Okay, this is the general form. But what is delta x? Delta x is equal to d sine theta. When it is very small, you said that it is d tan theta or d into y divided by capital D. Imagining this is your theta, so tan theta will be y divided by d, right? So dy by capital D is your delta x. Okay, now you have to find out the missing wavelengths. So the first, at which condition, at y is equal to d by 2, you have to find out what are the missing wavelengths. So when y is equal to d by 2, what happens to delta x? Delta x becomes, in the place of y you put d by 2, you are going to get d into d by 2, d square by 2d. D square by 2d, right? D square by 2d is the path difference at which coordinate at y is equal to d by 2. At y is equal to d by 2, between these two rays, what is the path difference? It is d square by 2d. So when d square by 2d, you take the first number in the series, when it is equal to lambda 1 by 2. What is this lambda 1? The first missing wavelength. At this point, what is the first missing wavelength we are finding out? So 2 by 2 cancel, lambda 1 will be equal to d square by capital D. Alright? You want to find out the second missing wavelength. This wavelength is missing at this position, that is why you are seeing the minima there. That is why you are seeing the dark spot there. Okay? If you want to find the second one, how much it will be? It will be d square by 2d will be equal to 3 lambda 2 by 2. So from here, 2 and 2 cancel, lambda 2 is equal to d square by 3d. Alright? If you want to find out the third missing wavelength, same d square by 2d. What is this d square by 2d? It is the path difference between the two light rays at this coordinate. This is the general equation for the path difference between the two light rays. For the third number in the series, you get 5 lambda. Why I have written lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3? I can write simply one simple lambda. No? These are different wavelengths. You know? At this location, these are all different wavelengths. All these wavelengths cannot be same. So, if two light rays, they have to form a destructive interference for this particular condition, just one of the missing wavelengths will be this value. Let us say that value is some 590 nanometer. This can be something else. This can be something else. We are finding the set of wavelengths which will create. Suppose you are given 10 set of wavelengths. 500, 550, 600, 650, 700, 750, like that. Alright? So, all these wavelengths will not be forming missing wavelength here. Will not be forming a dark wavelength here. Okay? Suppose you are given a set. 500, 550, 600, like that, which set you have provided. All these wavelengths will not be creating, you will not be getting this missing wavelength at this particular point. You will not be getting a dark spot. In that set, you are trying to find out which wavelengths are actually missing at this point. Okay? So, in that set, one wavelength is lambda 1. It is given by d square by d. Second one is given by d square by 3d. Third one is given by lambda 3d is d square by 5d. You can see there is a pattern there. Okay? D square by d, d square by 3d, d square by 5d. Next will be d square by 7d, d square by 9d. Like that, all those particular wavelengths will be missing at this location. They may be present at some other location, but here they will be missing. So this is the concept of missing wavelengths. And how did we get this? You have to remember this expression. This is for destructive interference. Okay? Take a screenshot and write down. So next, let us say there are two light rays of lambda 1 and lambda 2 wavelengths. Their wavelengths are lambda 1 and lambda 2. The condition given is the mth, or I will take the fourth maxima of lambda 1. You know, they are creating interference. The fourth maxima of the lambda 1 is matching with the seventh maxima of the second light. Okay, you can take it like this. The fourth maxima of lambda 1 is matching with the seventh maxima of lambda 2. So what is the ratio of lambda 1 and lambda 2? Or you can say the fourth minima of lambda 1. Some condition will be given in the question. You have to see. That means when you take the case of lambda 1, if you see the pattern, this is for lambda 1 and lambda 2. Alright. So here 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So the fourth is matching with the seventh. Okay. So you can say, let us not write it as maxima. The fourth fringe is matching with the seventh fringe of the second. Fourth fringe matching with the second fringe, seventh fringe of the second light. Okay. Then the question is, what should be the ratio of lambda 1 by lambda 2? So what we will do in this case, we will say that we will take the condition of let us say that the dark fringes of the first one is matching with the dark fringes of the second one. You know, the dark cannot match with the bright fringe, right? Doesn't make sense. So dark to dark you can compare, or bright to bright you can compare. So if I take the dark case, so what was the general equation? It was 2n minus 1 by 2 lambda d by small d. In both the cases, the screen distance is capital D and the slit gap is small d. Okay. So we will say that 2n minus 1 by 2 into lambda d by d for the dark fringe I am talking about. So this will be equal to 2m minus 1 by 2 lambda d by small d. But here we are talking about the first wavelength lambda 1, the second wavelength lambda 2. Okay. So this is the condition we need to apply. So here what are you getting? These two are common. See, understand the question. What I am basically saying is, a condition will be given, two wavelengths are given to you, alright, and some condition will be given, that is the fourth fringe of lambda 1 is matching with the seventh fringe of the second light or the lambda 2. Okay, suppose in the condition it is given that it is dark fringes, okay, then you have to apply this condition. If bright fringes was given, you have to use the formula for the bright fringes. So you need to equate these two. Just to understand it, this is the situation. Okay. So let us say the fringes were formed, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4. I am calling this as the central maximum. Okay. And here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I mean, they should be here. The central maximum of this light ray, may be different from the central maximum of this light ray. But what is matching is, the fourth fringe is matching with the seventh fringe of the lambda 2. Or let us say the nth fringe is matching with the nth fringe of the second light ray. Okay. So going by this, 2 cancel. So you are getting here lambda 1 by lambda 2 is equal to 2m minus 1 by 2n minus 1. Okay. So what is the m value here? It is 2 into 7 minus 1 to 2 into 4 minus 1. Okay. So 14 minus 1, 13 divided by 8 minus 1, 7. So the wavelengths must be in the ratio of 13:7 to get this condition. The wavelengths must be in this ratio to get this condition. Now suppose in another type of question, lambda 1, lambda 2 values are provided to you. Let us say, one, we are talking about two light rays. Same question in a different fashion. 450 nanometer is the wavelength of the first light and 600 nanometer is the wavelength of the second light. And they say that in this situation, which fringes will be matching with each other. Like in the previous case, what happened? The condition given was the fourth fringe was matching with the seventh fringe. There you have found out the ratio of wavelengths. Now, here the wavelengths are provided to you and they are asking you which order of the first case, first wavelength, you know, this is the first wave, this is the second wavelength, right? This corresponds to 450, this corresponds to 600. Obviously fringes are formed here, and here also fringes are formed here, isn't it? Some will be matching exactly. So they are asking you which are those fringes which will be matching with each other. Okay, this is another way of asking. Now in this situation also we will apply the same thing. We will say that, let us say I talk about the dark fringes. So for the dark fringes, 2n minus 1 by 2, I am calling this as n and I am calling this as m. Okay, this is lambda 1 and lambda 2. So 2n minus 1 by 2 into lambda d by capital D. Now in this condition also, the screen distance and the slit gap is same for both the interference experiments. Okay, the screen distance and the slit gap is same for both the conditions. So here for this one, 2n minus 1 by 2 into lambda d by d is equal to 2m minus 1 by 2 into lambda d by d. So here lambda 1, lambda 2, but those values are given to you. Alright, d by d is anyway common. So here what you will get, let us simplify this, we are getting 2n minus 1 into lambda 1, write the value here. Since everything is in nanometer, we simply put the value. 450 is equal to 2m minus 1 and this is 600 by 450. Alright, so 154s, 153s, so 4 by 3, 2n minus 1 by 2n minus 1, you are getting the condition 4 by 3. Okay, so what is the meaning of this? The meaning of this is the third fringe, let us say I call this as 1 and 2. Okay, the third fringe of the second wavelength is matching with the fourth one of the first one. Next, multiply this 8 by 6, again is 4 by 3. So 6th of the second is matching with the 8th of the first. Next, 16 by 12, right? Next, 24 by 32. 32 by 24. That means the 24th fringe of this will be matching with the 24th fringe of this will be matching with the 32 of the first one, and corresponds to the 1. No, so here if this is, we'll write here numbers. If this is 3, this is 4. If this is 6, this is 8. If this is 12, this is 16. That means the third fringe will be matching with the fourth, sixth will be matching with the eighth, 12th will be matching with the 16th, and so on. Alright? How about multiplying this with 1.5? Can you do that? Then what will happen? See, I took in the same ratio. I took the integral multiples. Okay? I took the integral multiples. If I multiply with 1.5, all that. If you multiply with 1.5, what will happen? 4 into 1.5, you will get 6. But 3 into 1.5, you get 4.5. Okay? What is this 4.5 fringe? What is this 4.5 fringe? So, you have to follow this pattern. Okay? Multiply with integral numbers. Multiply with 1, 4 by 3 into 1 by 1. 4 by 3 into 2 by 2. 4 by 3 into 3 by 3. 4 by 3 into 4 by 4. Okay? So, you can say that the 6th fringe, what is 4.5 fringe? 4.5 fringe is not justifiable, right? So this is the pattern it will create. Okay, understand the difference between the two questions. In the previous question, you are finding the ratio. That means you are finding these two values for a particular case. In that, it was told that the fourth fringe is matching with the seventh fringe. What is the ratio of the wavelengths? Here, the wavelengths are given to you, and what is being asked? Which order is matching with the second? Now, all these are orders of the first wavelength. All these are orders of the second wavelength. So you can say that the fourth order of 450 is equal to seventh order. Seventh order what? Fringe only, na? We are talking about fringes here. Seventh order fringes of 600. Like that you should interpret. Okay? Like that you should interpret. Okay? So pause it and take a screenshot. In some other type of question, they will give you a lambda value, 600 nanometer. They will give you the six size as A is equal to 0.1 nm. Alright. And they will ask you to find out fourth order. Angular divergence. Fourth order angular divergence they will ask you. Now where this term angular divergence comes means, we have done this diffraction experiment, you know. We have done this single slit. I told you that the single slit will be giving you diffraction pattern. And here also we have calculated the ordinates. Remember? We have calculated this and all this. Remember the values? So we will call this as, this is sin theta is equal to lambda by a. Here sin theta is equal to lambda by 2 lambda by a. Remember? Sin theta is equal to 3 lambda by a. Now he is asking you what is fourth order angular divergence. What are all this? These are all angular divergence only. Okay? The fourth order angular divergence is this. Alright, so you have to find out this, let us say theta 4, you have to find out. So don't get confused by this term, fourth order, it can be nth order, angular divergence. This is angular divergence. The angle was supposed to be going like this, but because the slit is very small, it took a deviation. So that is what is angular divergence. So here, sin theta is equal to, how what you have to take, because in the question, fourth order he mentioned. So 4 into lambda by a, you have to find out theta. Just I wanted to tell about this term, okay. So here sin theta will be equal to 4 into, it is 600 nanometers, so it is 600 into 10 power minus 9 meters divided by, it is 0.1 mm, so it is 0.1 into 10 what mm into meters, so 10 power minus 3. Alright? And then whatever value of theta you get, for that particular angular divergence, you get the fourth order diffraction pattern. Fourth order diffraction pattern. So these are some of the points which I wanted to discuss with you. And regarding any other doubts, you can directly message me. We have created that group also, you know. Evenings you can post your doubts. Any other concept by mistake I have missed, or some other additional concepts, I will try to cover in the form of doubts. So this much information is enough for you. Okay. See the previous ones also. And now start working with your HCV and all that, and come to me with your doubts. Alright.